shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Sing unto him the song of the redeemed. Lift up a banner, banner of worship. He is our Savior, our King. Shout unto God with a voice. Sing unto him.
Is risen. He is risen indeed. God bless you. Happy Tuesday to everyone out there. Thank you for logging on. Thank you for joining in this time of prayer. Hey, I want to welcome all of you, and I want to welcome you to like and to comment and to share, subscribe. to this live experience. Hey, what is your I am statement for today? Again, I am ready to lead us in prayer today. That's our purpose. That's our focus on right now. And want to get to that in just a moment as we pray or prepare to pray for our leaders. Listen, the Jaywalking Challenge is still upon us. We are reading through the book of Joshua. We are right there. Come on, Joshua chapter number 24 today. If you haven't done that already, get on that. Pull up and pray is still on our agenda. We want to continue to do that. Listen, we are getting really, really close to our Fiesta Fall Festival this Saturday, October the 31st. Looking forward to having a wonderful, great time with that. Listen, our Fiesta medals will be there and available as well. Listen, praise God. We're going to just have a wonderful time. So looking forward to all of you hanging out. Communion on November the 1st, first Sunday in November. Don't forget to come pick up your supplies. We've talked about that. You can do it on Sundays between 9 and 11, on Wednesdays between 11 a.m. and 1, and then on Wednesday evening, 6 p.m. and 7:30 p.m. Hey, let's get to the business of praying today. We're praying for our leaders. I want to ask you to turn and join me at 1 Timothy chapter number 2, if you can. 1 Timothy chapter number 2, verses 1 and 2. Here's Paul, inspired of the Holy Spirit, writing this letter to his little brother in ministry, Timothy. And he says to him, in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1, therefore I exhort, first of all, that supplications, there it is, prayers, intercessions, and giving of thanks be made for all men. And then he specifically says, for kings and all who are in authority. Here's why: that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and in reverence. What a prayer. What a prayer. Yesterday I wore a shirt just kind of supporting one of our local teams, track teams that the church has undergirded a little bit or in the past. Today I'm wearing, I think, the San Antonio Police shirt. As we pray for our leaders, I want to include them as they are guardians and give leadership in the community. I know some of y'all, why are you praying for the police? Listen, all police are not bad. We've got some bad apples, definitely. We've got to deal with that, and we've got to do something about that, and we cannot be silent about that. But let's pray for them as well. Let's pray for all of the persons who are leading as police officers, or even the sheriff's office or constables, so even security. All right, let's do that. Let's go into our model prayer. And then after our model prayer, we'll be praying for our leaders in this time of election season. Y'all, we're getting close to the closing of early voting and getting close to the actual day, November the 3rd. Hey, let's pray. Can we do that? Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Praise be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us, Lord, our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. Lead us not into temptation, but, Lord, deliver us from all sin and evil. Why? For thine is the kingdom, it's your kingdom, the power and the glory, all of that belongs to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Lord, we're praying today. We haven't given up. We're praying. You've given us the power to hold the weight. We are praying with the burden of our church and community, country, and world on our shoulders. We are praying. Lord, sympathetically and empathetically, we are praying with passion and compassion. We are praying with a loving and benevolent spirit. We are praying, Lord, and we want to have the right attitude. We don't want to just pray and just say a whole lot of words and think that you're going to hear us for our much speaking. We don't want to just pray, Lord, and stand outside to receive the accolades and applause of man. No, God, We're praying not in a fake way, but in a real way. Not as hypocrites, not pretending, but in a real way. We are praying, and Lord, it is not ours just to be saying things, vain repetition, saying the same thing over and over and not meaning it. Lord, if we do pray for the same things, we mean it every time. It's not vain. It may be repetitious at times, but not vain. Matter of fact, Lord, you taught us to persevere in prayer. You told us, Lord, in that example of that woman who kept coming. And Lord, we're going to keep coming to the throne. We feel welcomed at the throne. You told us we can come not timidly, not shyly, if you will, not in fear, but you said we can come boldly to the throne. So we are not afraid. We are comfortable standing before your throne, even though we know we don't deserve it. We don't deserve an audience with you. We don't deserve to be in your office talking to you. Oh, what a wonderful God we serve. Thank you, Lord. We have been stained, but yet washed. Thank you, Lord. We have messed up, but you've given us mercy. We've been grimy, but God, you have given us your amazing grace. We pray, Lord, for our leaders. We pray for our political leaders. We pray for our governmental leaders. And Lord, and what a time to pray for this in this season in our country, in America, as we are in election season, not just for the highest office in this land, but for other offices as well. And Lord, we pray right now for everyone who's in the office present, everyone who's in the office running again for that office, everyone who is not in an office but running for an office. We pray for all of them. We pray for the process. We pray for the judges. We pray, God, for senators. We pray for the House. We pray for governors, God. We pray for mayors. We pray for those who are just giving leadership at the polls, even right now in this time of voting, God. We pray for that process. We pray, Lord, for the outcome, that it would be an outcome and it would be aligned to your will and way in the name of Jesus. We pray for the protection of the voters when they go and vote, God. Some people are trying to intimidate voters, trying to discourage voters. But Lord, we thank you for in this country that we have the privilege, the right to be able to do so. May we understand the responsibility that comes with being a citizen and having this privilege to vote. Thank you, Lord, for the report of the numbers being high and up now. May we continue, Lord, to do that and not drop. Lord, we pray for the right person to be in the Oval Office, the right person to be in these seats and in these places, God, in these positions, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Lord, you told us to pray for them, Lord. You told us to pray for them, Lord, that we may lead a quiet life. Lord, even if the world or the country is not going in the way of the kingdom, we still pray that we might have some quiet, that we might have some peace, that we might be able to live out our godly lives, Lord, and do it with respect and reverence for you, Lord. You said this is good. You said this is acceptable in your sight. This is your will, Lord, the Savior God who desires all men to be saved in the name of Jesus. We know, Lord, there's one God. We know there is one mediator between God and man, and we know it is Jesus the Christ. So, Lord, we pray in his name. Lord, I'm wearing a shirt representing law enforcement, the guardians of our city, the guardians, sheriffs of our county. I want to lift up every law enforcement person in our city, in our county, in our state, but in every city, in every county, in every state, Lord, all over the world, God. Want to lift them, Lord. I know as a part of government, you have established these positions. You have established these offices, God. We know that every person in the office does not honor you, but Lord, we pray for them that don't honor you or those that don't even know you. We pray for those that do honor you, God, and may they be re-energized and revived and renewed, Lord, to continue to do a good job according to your will. Father, we bless you, God, in the name of Jesus. We pray for the families of all of these leaders as well, who send their spouses or their parents out to do these jobs and sit in these positions, God. We pray for them and their safekeeping as well, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you for the opportunity to pray, to lift up these leaders, Lord. I know we haven't talked about leaders in the church, but let me lift them up, God, because you have put the church here, Lord, to be your voice. You put the church here, Lord, to be light. You put the church here, Lord, to be salt. You put the church here to be an example. You put the church here to evangelize. You put the church here to pray. You put the church here, God, to love in the name of Jesus and to do good. You put us here as your ambassadors, as your representatives. You've put us here, Lord, as stewards over the ways of the kingdom. So, Lord, bless your church, bless the leadership, even of your church. In Jesus' name, I pray even now for those who are praying with me online, praying with me on Facebook, YouTube, the phone line. Thank you, Lord, for their tenacity to keep it going, to keep up praying, God. Thank you for them and their strength. I love you, God. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Hey, I don't know if I've told you this, but I'm very encouraged that you're here and to pray. And thank you for logging on, setting your clock, or just getting the notice and clicking on. Thank you so much for those of you who just logged on. Hey, for those of you who will log on later on in the day, praise God for every one of you for just doing it. Hey, it means much that we are together in praying. Don't forget now to early vote. Hey, Bible study and lunch with the Lord tomorrow. Lunch with the Lord at 12 noon, tomorrow at noon. Bible study at 7 o'clock. Yeah, tomorrow night. All right. Hey, love you with the love of the Lord. Hey, hugs and kisses to you all. Bye-bye.
Yay, Ma. Come on. You know.
Yes, sir.
Now, the next time you drive by somebody living up under a bridge,
come on.
Now, the next time you want to complain, remember this. No job.
Outside all alone.
Sitting trying to figure out
where I went wrong.
Can somebody help me?
Tell me what do I do?
Can't feed my kids need
money for the rent.
Bills at the bills and
everything's clear.
The enemy is telling me.
Might as well quit.
The tears in my eyes crying.
Lord, please hear me.
See, that's the reason.
I just need